Howdy, guys. See all that dirt on the wheel? It was just pouring here. Unbelievable. Torrential freaking downpour. That was my soda can that I was just drinking. It was just pouring a few minutes ago. And, yeah, I had just gotten the mufflers done on the mower. And I wanted to take it out and... just the sky opened up. I mean, look at that. It's brought mud up on top of the grass because it was raining so hard. Freaking crazy. The street was flooded, and this road never floods, so that was something else. Yeah, that could have been a quarter inch of rain in an hour or freaking more. Everything's soaking wet. But look at all the crap in our fuel filter already. It's because it had no gas cap on it. Sat around in the shop with no fuel cap. These came out a little lopsided here, as you can see. For some reason, this pipe nipple screwed in more than this one. I don't know if either the end of the pipe is in the way, I didn't grind it back as far, or this one I didn't have the nipple screwed in while I was welding the elbow onto the pipe, which that's my mistake, but so maybe there's some weld spatter in there or something. There was a couple pieces of it that I knocked out of there. Maybe there's a piece that I missed, but it's tight, it won't come off. And that one's all marked up because I had a strap wrench on it, so you know, it is what it is. But she runs good now, sounds a lot quieter. She ran all right before. She ran just fine before. That's a safety feature on this lawnmower. That's like a park for the joystick, so you can't move it. Just like on the two-handle ones where the handles flip out and they lock in place. And if the parking brake's on or you're off the seat, if the parking brake's on and this is out where you know you can drive it, it doesn't want you to... They don't want you to try to drive it with the parking brake on, so it shuts the engine down. Or if you're not sitting on the seat and it's not in park, you know, it shuts the engine off for safety. And since we're going to be selling this lawnmower, we're not disabling any of the safety features, because that's just opening yourself up for a lawsuit. So this thing's about ready to go. We got to get that gas cap in. I ordered it on eBay, so that should be coming. I don't know how much water is getting in the fuel tank. I'm sure that saran wrap on there is not completely sealed. I know it's not, because it used to suck down in there when you started the engine because the fuel pump pulling fuel through, and it doesn't do that anymore, so it's got to be leaking somewhere. But those gas caps are kind of expensive. They're about $20. It's got the big three and a quarter inch fuel cap. Anyway, how to get a grease fitting. This is missing a grease fitting on this spindle. If I can find one and wind it in there and give it some grease, it'd be better for a selling point. But she's pretty well finished now, so that's good. I know that somebody just put this stupid, it's like a rake handle or something on there. So I guess the original handle busted off. Maybe nobody will notice. I don't know, but, you know, we got enough stuff to do around here, and, you know, I want to get out to the car show. By the way, this engine's going to be up for sale. Not that there's anybody locally. I'm not going to freaking try to ship it to somebody or whatever, but I'm going to be selling that engine because I have no use for it. I had thought about putting it on a go-kart or something, but I ain't got time for that kind of stuff anymore. We haven't gotten the sled put away yet because we've been so busy in the garage. We haven't been able to clear out a space for it. As soon as this car show's over and our vacation's over, we got some serious yard cleanup and garage cleanup to do. So that's going to be a lot of fun. We don't want it looking like a total trash dump around here, and it kind of does right now. So we got to fix that up. Anywho, Danny's going to be here any minute now, I think, if he's on schedule. He hasn't called me or anything, so I don't know, but he should be here within 20 minutes or so, I would think. But, cool blue lights or controlled explosions, whatever you want to call them on YouTube. He's on his way out here. He's coming with us to the car show. He's, he's just had his heart surgery and everything, and he's not quite back to work yet. He wants to have a little fun, get out a little bit before he goes back next week. So anyway, I'll be waiting for him to show up, and then I gotta bring my dad's already out there at the show, and I gotta bring him some tools because his friend's car's having some issues. He's got a 62 Impala, and it's like not charging a battery or whatever. He wants me to bring out voltmeter and some tools and shit. So we'll see how that goes. But now I'm gonna be at the Syracuse Nationals, biggest car show on the East Coast. If anybody's there, shoot me a personal message, and maybe we can meet up or whatever. I'm gonna have my pickup out there. You see, I got the stickers on the windshield. Old Lulu, she's gonna be out there. That's what the the second owner, the owner before me, they named it Lulu. But I'm sure this video is long enough, 7 minutes. So take care, guys, and hopefully we'll see you around.